Time to tag you. I'm going to tag you. Time to tag you. Time to tag you. Another episode of Tag Time. It's time to tag you. Another episode of Tag Time. I'm your host, Halima Sadia. Today we are going to talk about the Beauty Pageant Contest 2021 under the umbrella of Mrs. Universe Canada. We have with us the international director for this contest, Mr. S.V. Vadiwala. And along with him, I have in my studio with me the finalist of this pageantry, Mrs. Shannon Green. I welcome you both to my studio today. So let's start with you, SB. How would you like to tell us about this year's platform?
Good evening, Canada. Thank you, Halima Ji, for inviting us. I'm grateful that our finalist, Mrs. Shannon Green, is with us besides me. She's our real pride of honor for Canada, because she's a talented lady. And after a hectic search with over 11 or 12 ladies, I was able to pinpoint her, because she's the person who I can trust, rely, and groom her.
So how would you like to explain, like, how long have you been doing this pageant thing? And a little bit of introduction to the people who does not know yet that what is the kind of work it is.
As you are aware that, Limaji, I'm in the woman empowerment field since last 12 years. This is my 12th year, and hopefully it's the last, because this is the largest platform I'm doing, which is the world's largest platform for category of Mrs. and MS. And this took us 2 years, because we paid the royalty and the franchise license fee in early 2020 looking forward of doing in 2020, but nobody knew that COVID-19 is going to change the whole world, and we will be in so much of trouble, and still we are not out of it.
So how are you coping with that?
We did our manage. We faced the challenges. We have taken dose one already of COVID-19. We did very well from work via Zoom, media, communications, telephones, you know. So we kept the work going, and you won't believe, under such lockdowns also, we were managed to contact our vendors and get the things done. And now, tomorrow, God willing, we are going to have a first official photo shoot by our platform's official photographer, who is Eric Chen of Eric Chen Photography, who is working with me since last 11 years. He's the oldest media guy who works with us. And he has done a lot of women empowerment in his life. So we have started our campaign, the promotion for Shannon, with the opening of a TV, which is a warm-up, rather, for her to feel that she's our finalist, Mrs. Universe from Canada. I would like to say cheers and welcome to Shannon.
So let's come to Shannon. Shannon, how would you like to introduce yourself to our viewers?
Well, I'd like to first say thank you, Halima, for having us on your show today. Thank you to Aspi, our national director. My name is Shannon Green. I will be representing Canada as a finalist in Mrs. Universe Canada 2021 this year in November in Seoul, South Korea. And I'm very excited to be able to take this journey with Aspi, especially since it is going to be his last year in female empowerment in the pageantry world. It's quite awesome to be a part of.
So you're going to go to Korea this
Hopefully.
Year.
Pray for me. Okay. My health permits, because you have known that for 11 years, I have taken my delegates and I've fought like real hell, because over there competition is there. And this is the biggest and the largest in the world, with over 85, 90 ladies participating. It's the biggest. it will be a world experience for our Shen, because she still doesn't have the idea what it is. It's a very big. That's why we want her to do all the promotions over here. So there is nothing left unturned. Tomorrow, suppose if she has to go and represent Canada, raise our flag independently also, she's fully, fully able to do it. We will polish her 100%.
So let's come to Shannon, you. How and why were you into this pageant thing?
Besides my love of pageantry, I decided to get involved with Mrs. Universe Canada because it's an exciting opportunity and you learn so many skills along in the pageant world. I was approached by Aspie and the crew, the team, to take part in the pageant. I competed against 12 other females, and the day I got the phone call saying, you're our finalist, I'm like, whoa. It was quite exciting, and I'm glad I can take this journey to South Korea and be a part of this experience.
So how would you like to share with us your experiences of reaching from not being into a pageant and being a pageant, the finalist? So what are your feelings and what was the journey like?
Well, I've competed in local pageants before in the past, and I was the first runner-up. With all of that experience, it's led me up to this time here, being with you on the show today, being with Aspie to be a part of Mrs. Universe Canada. It was all about self-development and taking a lot of the skills from each show to today. Being a part of the show with Mrs. Universe Canada, I went through interviews with the director. I went through team meetings with the director. I went through question and answer period. So it was a lot of getting to know you and skill base, intelligent base, to actually be a part of this experience.
So how would you explain us about developing yourself or grooming yourself, or I would say, what is the learning point you got through all this journey so far?
Well, for me, what I would say is to know yourself first.
Definitely.
Love yourself, and don't pay attention to what everybody else is doing, because you're never going to be like the other female. You need to know yourself first, inside and out, and take all of the skills and experiences around you to be able to say, this is what works for me as a woman in this competition, and this may not work for me, but I'm willing to learn.
So for you, what is women empowerment? How would you express the meanings of women empowerment? Do you think they need that, or do you think that they are already empowered?
I would say, as a woman in whole, we are empowered, but there are some women that don't feel that they have the empowerment there. And us as females, that's where we need to come together as a team, as unity, and unify ourselves and help each other along the way in whatever journey or path we decide to take in life.
So COVID 2019 till now, and pageantry, as you are not new to it, you have a history of being
in that.
And
she's doing 2-3 platforms this year prior to leaving.
Okay.
She's going to do a very, very nice platform, which is my colleague rather. So I'm very hopeful because she'll get some good warm-up. Plus, I'm trying to put her in early November also. There is my friend is doing a pageant in Hamilton to get a feel of the stage, to meet the people, to meet the delegates, and what is woman empowerment. So she will have a lot of experience before she flies out from Canada. That's why we have worked out a thorough plan. You know, I work thoroughly. You have seen me working, not from today. You were there with me for 5 years at the Beauties of Asia. You recall our days in Markham? Yeah. How we had at the hotels and with our delegates, and when I had got Mrs. Universe Asia from USA, she was my personal guest. You met her, Suha Shi. And that was the lady who went to Mrs. Universe in 2015 as Mrs. Myanmar. Since that time, I had a desire in my heart that one day, before I step down from this woman empowerment work, which is a thankless job, let me tell you, I will definitely do Mrs. Universe, and I did it. It was a tough competition because the old directors and old people and lots of backbiting and backstabbing goes on around the world. This is also not a very clean thing. But to keep yourself clean, one has to be very protective, very clean. That is my motto. Otherwise, you cannot survive in a woman empowerment events and all for 11 years. People have come and vanished. You have seen. People who have no experience, people who have no objective, people who have taken it for just for making. I don't do for making any money or as money making or a business. It's my passion. Passion made me do for 12 years and I'll finally do this. I want to see her proud, winning, and she should feel proud of me and my team.
So let's come back for both of you as a director, as
National Director Canada,
and having this concept of women empowerment. To you, since you're a male and you work for women empowerment, to you, what this women empowerment means? And for you also, because of being a woman and into a pageantry, how would you express one after
another? Let me emphasize what is woman empowerment. It's a very, very huge field. When one starts speaking, you can speak for 10 minutes or maybe 1 hour even. It's a very wide field. Woman empowerment, how you see it, how you are going to groom a lady, what is your focus, what are your objectives, and how you can achieve. And that comes with experience. It doesn't come automatically by birth. I've gone through hell from in the beginning when I was doing pageants in Jamaica, because that time the United Nations people were just inclined that we should do pageants in Jamaica. We did for 4 years in Negril, and then we used to go up to Kingston and Ochorio's also to handle the international woman. Was not a joke, but it was a great, great experience. I learned a lot. I found my strengths, my weaknesses and everything, and I overcome my weaknesses. And I saw why other organizers, other national pageant platforms, they fail after doing 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, and they have gone and vanished. Whereas you saw, I came constantly with big world platforms. I did a very, very big platform. I completed in 2018 as Commonwealth. You took so many interviews of our Commonwealth delegates. And I'm proud to say that my 3 delegates won. 2 from Canada and 1 from India.
Wow.
Because that was also an international. And United Nations, I was the world director. We used to have delegates from around the world. Though I was based in Canada and Toronto, but we used to operate for the world. So I have my women who are empowered in Singapore, Malaysia, USA, France, Britain, blah, 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 Colombia,
so it's Venezuela. Universe, so it's everywhere. So let's come to Shannon. Shannon and women empowerment. Let's have some comments about it.
Well, women empowerment to me and in the pageantry world, in the business world, it's about helping one another, being there to support each other, whether it's on their platform, whether it's on their in their business world or on a personal level, right? Us as women, we each have our own strengths and weaknesses, and it's for each of us bring something out in each other, and we can learn from each other and help support each other on their journey in any aspect of their life.
So, coming back to you, what should the viewers expect from this year's Miss Universe?
As you know, I believe in best, and my Shannon is the best. That's what I always tell her. I don't see any other woman who can be best. And if God willing, with my health conditions, if I go there with her, I will do my level best, because there's a lot of work over there. But she's a very confident young lady. She's not immature. She's a very mature lady, very understanding, experienced. That was the reason. And she came last. You know, we inducted about 11 ladies in the month of Feb 2020. We inducted them very gracefully, everything. But nobody's stuck in my head or in my eyes. You are aware that I'm an international judge as well, certified international judge for pageant of women empowerment. So nobody was impressing. I used to tell my co-director off and on, Kigada, I'm not happy with this year's delegates. She came just last. I met her during COVID. Can you believe that? I met her during COVID and I had a direct communications with her. My sixth sense said, okay, if I can groom Shannon, I will be the most proud national director for Mrs. Canada, Universe Canada. Otherwise, a point came when I was thinking, no problem, money is not everything. Though we had paid in advance 50%, that will go. Because in pageant industry, as soon as you send the money to the organizer, they start investing for the bookings, the hotels, this, that, blah, blah. There are thousands of arrangements. Why I know? Because I used to do the whole arrangements in Jamaica, from sitting here with the resorts, the food, the arrangements, going out, transportation, logistics, all events, calling on dignitaries, going on a boat cruise, and many, many things. So it has taken years.
Yeah, it's a hard work.
It's a hard work. And I've given my full passion to work hard. You have seen me working.
Yeah.
Plus, you know, I'm a community worker, a political and a community worker from Canada. So that has given me more added advantage as far as the media is concerned, our politicians are concerned. Because
You have a lot of contribution. That is how
I was the director outreach for about 8 years for the Conservative Party of Canada.
Yeah.
I'm proud to say I stepped down 2 years ago because there is a time. I stepped down when I was at the peak. And now you know what the politics and where Canada is heading for, which I am not at all happy.
So let's come to Shannon. Shannon, how would you explain to our viewers, or how would you like to share with our viewers, that pageantry during COVID time and after COVID, how do you see how it is going to change, or it is already changed, or it is changing?
For pageantry during COVID, it's drastically changed. And the reason why I say that is because us as women, a sisterhood, we're used to being in person, going out and doing our charity work together, meeting in small groups, organizing events, and so forth. And now since COVID has happened, a lot of things has gone virtually. Things have been brought onto line. So it's trying to organize fundraisers online, not having our sisters beside us to do it in person. But going forward, on different platforms, they're trying to work it both ways and continue as best as we can. Me personally, I love it in person because you can build genuine relationships. You get to meet with the ladies to go out and do your charity work.
It's entirely different.
It's entirely different.
It's a very, very different.
And let me add one more thing for our viewers of Tech TV and for the information of, I think Shannon is aware of it, that last year Mrs. Universe did the pageant event, but visually, online.
Online.
And they came to me first, will Canada? I said, no. I'm not a man who would do visually. And visually, everything is possible. I've been on the judges' table so many times. I know what happens and how it happens and all that stuff. And how you are going to judge when you hardly see the lady performing. You hardly see how she sits, how she talks, how she manages, how well-groomed she is. You can't judge with such a huge crowd. They said, no, that is... I said, no, you can give it to somebody else. I will go for 2021 in person. And that was the promise I took from them. And since then, it was the longest run. You know, it's more than 1 year and about 5 months have passed since the time. And we are still going on. But now I'm hopeful with the current opening from Friday, our patios are opening. And I started 2 days before with the TV interview. Tomorrow there is a professional photo shoot. Next week we are going to induct her with sash and crown. We will be, hopefully if I catch any of our MPPs, we will invite him or her also to be present. So it creates a grace for her. An image building for the platform, image building for the national director and for Canada.
So let's, before we conclude this, I would, you were wrapping up this, this is, as you're saying, going to be your last.
Hopefully. God willing, I may change my mind.
Okay.
If the beautiful ladies, they don't allow me. Much.
Yeah, because experience also, it's hard to build.
It's better to be on the advisory board because so many platforms has asked me to be their advisor. Not only from Canada, from but there are from some foreign countries as well. Guys should be on the board. Because I'm now even refusing the judging also as judge too. I just refused during COVID as a visual judge for Miss Canada Perfect. I said, I don't feel that comfortable. I'll be playing my role, fair role, because I'm the strictest judge.
Yeah.
People who knows me, they get frightened. Oh my God, he's the judge. He's not going to give us a score. You can ask my ladies and other ladies of other platforms too. They will say no, he's going to judge really, really very, very tight.
So what are your standards? On which standards do you judge? Because pageantry itself is not judging like you judge things. So you have to have certain...
I strictly follow the international manual for the woman empowerment given to me as a proud national world director by United Nations International Pageant Inc., USA. And I follow. That is like a Bible to me. Believe me. I off and on, it has got each and everything what a woman empowerment should do or we should do as an organizer, as a director, as a delegate. Why are the other organizers fail to do so many things and I do so many new things? Unluckily or unfortunately, you can say during 2020 till August, we did a three beautiful events, promotional events on Mrs. Universe platform. We had a very beautiful lunch and a photo shoot at the lakeshore in Burlington, your city, where there is a palace over there. Mm-hmm. There is an event palace. So we took a special permission, we did the photography there. We had a lunch at the Spencer's in Burlington, and how the ladies they enjoyed. After that, I even arranged a very new thing this time before the lockdown. We hired a limo. We took all our ladies, about 12 ladies were there, the media was there, and the director team, they took them from Mississauga to Niagara Falls. And during the limo ride, they would feel that they are VIPs, because majority of the country and the big platforms, they received their queens in a limo. When about 4 or 5 ladies arrived together with intervals of little half an hour, 1 hour, they gather them, make them sit in the lounge, and then they collect them and take them and make them feel like real queens. You know, I was about to arrange a cruise also of Lake Ontario and a photo shoot. But by that time, the lockdown killed us. And our program of Niagara was the last. We left Mississauga at 5 p.m. in the evening. We came around midnight. And during our way to Niagara Falls, we had given them a real, real enjoyment. We had a music in the limo.
And the
we
learning, opened a champagne. Learning with yeah, learning. All that is that
it was a fun
you
day.
Learn to be together.
Yeah, be together.
And how to enjoy and how to
be a good team player.
Team player.
Then I gave them a taste of chocolate and strawberries. They took a toast of champagne before reaching Niagara Falls.
These are all, I think, the
these
part
are all
of
the part
pageant.
Of perks.
So let's talk about a little bit that. How would you, what suggestions would you like to give to the people who are looking forward to have their careers in such fields, since you have a lot of experience?
Again, I would like to clarify over here, I don't do beauty pageant. The word beauty, I don't like that much. I do woman empowerment, because in my life, I've never done a single fashion show which sells a product, which portrays a woman. I was the man who fought tooth and nail with the organizers of United Nations that I'm not happy with the bikini round. Because the women in Jamaica and other African countries, they wear a very skimpy bikini. And there were few incidences which I would not like to comment also. So I was not at all in favor of having a bikini round. And in the final 4th year, I was successful. Though I got a threat from the Jamaican girls delegates that if the bikini round is not there, we will boycott the pageant. I said, go ahead, do it, whatever you want. The rules are the rules. It has been finalized by the board. You can wear a sportswear. We turn into a sportswear round.
So you're trying to suggest that women this whole thing has rules and fundamental rules.
Women are to be respected.
From wearing, the thing is, bikini wearing is not disrespectful
at all. Not respectful.
But it depends upon how
it depends
you
upon
wear.
The crowd.
Where you
it
wear.
Depends upon the country.
About
it depends upon the audience.
Country.
You know.
I think it's the place and the environment where you are doing is a lot.
You know, I don't want that. I'm judging a pageant where the boys are whistling and hooting and God knows giving all cheap remarks and all. I noticed that, and then that's why I even stopped taking misters. We did 2 years for mister also, but with some very very unpleasant experiences. I said I'm not going to have a mister in any woman empowerment event in future.
So let's come back to what would you like to give as a suggestion to the people who are looking
forward. My suggestion to all the ladies who wants to get empowered, and especially the ladies who are married and who has not fulfilled their heart's desires, they should join before it's too late for them, because woman empowerment life is too short. It's not a long life. That's what I told Shannon 3-4 times. Don't count me wrong. When you are at the peak, then you have got a desire, fulfill it. And now you are in a position to do it. What you did not do when you were miss or unmarried. So I would again suggest to all our ladies who in future also would like to take part in women empowerment to remain focused, love what you are doing, overcome your weaknesses, and be a team player. And always be a loyalist to your country.
So, Shannon, do you, since you have an experience, like a long experience of pageantry, so a lot of women and a lot of girls even, they have very much attraction towards this. So what would be your suggestion to those people who are looking forward to step into this pageantry world?
For the females who want to get involved in pageantry, I would say step into it with an open mind and be yourself. Do not lose yourself in the experience. From it, you will gain a great networking experience, life skills, and great friendships along the way.
So, usually pageantry is affiliated with beauty. Mm-hmm. To you,
definitely.
What is beauty? How would you like to express what is beauty?
To me, beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
True.
And beauty comes from within.
And inside out. It's not only the outer look what I see when
it's
we take
what's
a,
inside that
what
really
inside
matters.
how brilliant the person is, how intelligent the person is. I did lots of interviews with very beautiful ladies, but I did not approve, I did not mark them, because they are going to be dummies on the stage. What's the use? Person should have sharp features, intelligent, motivation, determination.
I wouldn't say so much dummy.
No. It's not a thing. But there are.
No,
there are.
But I understand what you're saying. There's a lot of beautiful women who enter these competitions. But at the same time, you can consider some of them ugly. Because it's the attitude. When I say ugly, I mean the attitude. The
positive attitude
that comes behind it. It's just
a
negative spirit vibe that they release off onto everybody else, energy-wise. But there are some beautiful women that do not have a beautiful spirit. And I would say make sure you're genuine and you're beautiful from the inside out.
So that topic has come. Sorry for interruption. Let me give you one small incident in London at the United Nations. A third degree burn delegate appeared as a delegate. And everybody was just looking at her as if ridiculing her. She did some cosmetic surgeries and all that, but still, all her scars on her hands, neck, everything was
but
showing.
Wasn't that a special NGO which was doing the pageantry for
No, no, we had no criteria. We judged her as a female. As for woman empowerment, how intelligent she was, how determined she was, how articulate she was. And you won't believe, that woman won the crown.
Yeah.
And I told everybody, even my team who was not, okay, why are you taking such a big risk? She has come, it's our duty to give her a full ride. take the interview, give her a chance. I said, no, I see spark in her. I see she will do something better. If she was burnt, it was not by intention. She was burnt by accident. But this woman is really graceful inside out. She's intelligent. And she can really serve other women and be an example of a woman.
Yeah. So, Shan, I'm coming back to you. What are your goals and what is the future for pageantry for you?
My goals for using my title as Mrs. Universe Canada is first to enjoy my experience, continue my charity work. Right now, I am involved with an organization called Moms for Moms, and what we do is assist new mothers with necessities to start their journey, or mothers that are just getting out of shelters to start a new life. So I would like to continue that on my platform. For the future of pageantry itself, I believe pageantry will always be there because there's so many different platforms where you can get involved just for philanthropy. You'll have the beauty contest, Strictly Beauty, that you mentioned, and you'll have intelligent-based or charity-based pageants. There's so many different opportunities out there, and it will help you get forward with your platform and your journey.
I thank you both and wish you very good luck for your upcoming events and all journey. And I hope to see you continuing because with this experience,
my belief is that... You'll be my largest, biggest supporter, that I know.
Yeah, I know that experience matters a lot because when you have done so much struggle, then it's time to grow and groom different people again, like in the industry and pageantry also.
My Mrs. Universe will be there. I'd be proud if she comes with the title or no problem. I'm going to promote her for the whole year. That's what I told her. We are not the platform who would sleep after the pageant, who would sleep before the pageant. We keep on doing things, empowering them. And with each promotional event, she's going to learn. And she herself will soon realize now that no, this platform, whatever they do, whatever they say, they are committed.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you for having us.
Beauty to me is to believe yourself, to believe in your potentials and your possibilities, and to have faith that you can make a difference as an individual in the world around you and the world as a unit too. As far as empowerment of a woman is concerned, women are very empowered because they give a child birth. If they can bear that, they are very strong. Empowerment, which we talk about taking with different type of scenarios, is that we help each other to grow, groom, and explore our potentials and make a difference if we have time and energies provided for that kind of scenario. So we would always consider that society is based on individual, and each and every individual has a right and responsibility to be productive and part of the society. Healthy societies build healthy minds, and healthy mind brings out beautiful women. We need men to come forward to support women to use their potentiality and make a huge difference in your lives and the world around them. With these words, thank you very much for watching Tag Time with Halima Sadia today. Time to tag you. I'm going to tag you.
Time to tag you.
Time to tag you. Another episode of Tag Time.